Hello everyone. So now I will show you how to draw the schematic and layout for experiment number 2, that is common source amplifier. Okay, so I will start with the drawing the schematic and layout. So we'll double click on electric. We'll arrange it. First, file. New library. Here I'll type the name of the library as cs_amplifier. Click OK. So then right click on the library name, then create new cell. So in that, select schematic, view the name of the schematic. The name of the schematic is CS amplifier. Then press OK. So now select the schematic icon, then press Ctrl G to get the grids. So now I will move on to the components so that I can draw the schematic. So move on to the components, click on components, select PMOS, place it on the grid. So zoom it so that we can do a proper connection. So this is a PMOS. First thing, go to the tools, simulation spice, then set spice model, then name it as PMOS. So then again select it. So here we have to increase the width of PMOS to 50 so that we can get a proper amplification. So now double click on it, so make the width as 50. Then press OK. Then press C. Only you have to press the C in the keyboard. So this window will be appear. In that, go to the 4 transistor. In that, you have to select PMOS 4. Then click change. Then click on done. So then double click on it. Then click on more here. Then click on mirror left to right. Apply. OK. So we will get this one. So this is a complete construction for PMOS in common source amplifier. So then similarly I have to do it for NMOS. So click on NMOS, place it on the grid, then go to the tools, simulation spice, set spice model. Then select this spice model, double click on it, make it as NMOS. So next, select NMOS, so double click on it, make the width as 10, then click OK. So then you have to make it as 4 terminal NMOS transistor, press C in the keyboard, you get this window, then go to 4 port transistor which is there, then select NMOS 4 here, then click on change, then done. So we got PMOS and NMOS. So now we have to connect the pins. So select the pin here. So place it on the one pin required for the gate of PMOS, and one pin is required for the gate of NMOS. One pin for supply, and one pin for ground. So then we have to name them. So select first input. Press Ctrl E. Make it as V. And select it as input. Then click OK. So this is VIN. So just arrange it properly. Next, another input, Ctrl E. Make it as V bias. You have to select the spellings properly. Again, it is also input. Click on OK. Just arrange it properly so that we can do the connection. This is VSS, press Ctrl E, make it as VSS, then this should be ground. Then click on OK. Then rotate it, press Ctrl J, arrange it properly so that we can do the connection. So I will place exactly in the same way. Then we will go for the supply, Ctrl E, make it as VDD. Then select power. press OK. So arrange it properly so that you can do the connection. Then rotate it. Then place it properly to the grid. So we got all pins and the MOS transistors. Next is we need to do the connections to the input and output side. Okay, we left another one, V out. So take another pin, place it at the output side, then press Ctrl E, make it as V out, then select it as output. So arrange it so that you can do the connections. Done. So now first thing, we'll do the connection for the input. Left click here, right click here. So we got the input. Next, you connect V bias, left click here, right click here. We got the bias. Then short these two terminals to connect the output. So I'll connect the output here. Done. Next, you have to supply from this terminal, that is drain, to the VD. So done. So if the extra wire is there, just delete it properly by selecting it. Selected both, so Ctrl J, only select this wire and delete, so that you can do the, without using extra wire, we need to connect. So from here to only this part. So done. So next, we have to connect the source. So left click, right click on this one. Done. Next, we have a bulk terminals. Click on this bulk terminal properly, left click. Click outside here like this. Then click here with the continuation. Then click, this is right click. So click here, it will connect properly. So without any extra wire shorted, you need to connect it properly. Similarly for NMOS, first left click on this. Then click somewhere here, right click. Continue with that right click here. Then continue and connect it to the VSS. So done. So this is a connection for the schematic of common source. I hope it is completed. Next, go to the SPICE, click on SPICE. There, click on, so wait a second. Click on miscellaneous, I hope, as miscellaneous. Then click on SPICE code. So place it on the grid. So I will place here. Okay, so next, I need to write the SPICE code. So I already written here in this presentation. So I'll just copy it. This is a SPICE code for the input. So Ctrl C. I'll just place it on the text. So this one, first press Ctrl I. So we'll get this window. Okay, I think I've done a mistake. So close it, select it, press Ctrl I. So here, select multi-line text. So delete this text, then press Ctrl V to copy the code. We got the code. So first, we need to perform transient analysis. So dot TRAN. So ranges from 0 to 10 milli. So then apply. OK. So now, once this is done, save it. Click on save. So saving it as cs_appjla. So in the electric folder itself. So if you won't get this, so you have to go to the desktop or this PC. Then there, local disk C. There, electric. There, you have to save it. So save it. So now the file is saved. Now I'll do the simulation. So go to the tools. So before that, check the any errors. Check hierarchically. Go to Explorer. So check that is there any errors here. So no errors. Okay. So I will remove this one. So no errors. I'll check once again. Tools, DRC. Check hierarchically. No errors. So now I will go for the simulation tools. Simulation SPICE. Right, SPICE deck. So here you get this window. So run it. So select the input and output and check the output. So this is VIN. So good for the IR plate pin. Then again, click on this traces, select Vout. Look, see here, the input ranges from 0 to 5 millivolts with positive and negative cycle, and the output voltage is amplified around 1.6121 volts. So this is the amplification we have got. If the supply voltage ranges from 0 to 2.5 volts. This is the waveform, amplified output, common source. Here the input and output have a phase shift of 180 degrees, means that the input side, if I have a positive cycle, at the output side should get a negative cycle. So we are getting that. From this I can say that there is a 180 degree phase shift between the input and output. So this is for transient. Similarly, you can do it for DC and AC analysis. So now I will do it for DC analysis. So here, this is the code for DC. So just copy it instead of writing. You guys should write that one. Then go to the this one. Press Ctrl I. Only transient analysis you have to remove, and there you have to copy DC analysis. Then apply. Okay. Save it. Go to the tools, simulation, right specific. So here for DC, click on traces, select both input and output. So input, then output. Click OK. So this is the response for DC analysis. Same as we got the inverter, the same thing we have got here. Only the change is that the DC which you are verifying it from minus 2.5 volts to 2.5 volts. So the response is again same. When the input increases from 0 to, that is minus 2.5 to 2.5, the output will be exactly opposite, because there is a 180 degree phase shift. So ranges from maximum of 2 volts here. So this is the delay, or we call it as, this is a pass band, means it is allowing this voltage. Again, when the voltage reaches to the 2.5, so it should become 0. So that's why this is the attenuation or slope, which makes, because of delay, it will reach slowly towards the negative part. Okay, so that's why this is from negative to positive, this is from positive to negative, minus 2.5. So this is about DC analysis. Similarly, I have to do it for AC. So there we have to verify the gain in decibels. So for that, so here I will show you for AC analysis. So move on to that. So copy the AC. You have to type there, Control C. So click on this PiSCode code, Control I. Then only change the DC. That is, becomes AC now. So then apply, OK. Then go to the, so save it, tools, simulation spice, write spice. So now here also, select input and output. Control V in, V out. Okay. Do one thing, we will, this is, we are not getting the correct answer because it's not showing proper. So we will select V in and V out separately. So I will close it again. Okay. So close this. So again, go to the tools, simulation spice, write spice depth. Okay. Maximize, select only V out. So this is the waveform we need to get for the AC analysis. Okay, so here, as the frequency ranges from 100 Hz to up to nearly 100 megahertz, here the gain of the common source amplifier, which is minus 2.6, remains constant. So as soon as, means remains constant, means now this amplifier is in active region. Okay, or in amplification region, which is also called as saturation. For the MOS transistors, we call this as saturation. This is a non-saturation. So as soon as the frequency increase of the input voltage from 100 to 1 gigahertz, so here it starts falling, okay, and reaches almost to zero. It is entering into the non-saturation region. Okay, so this is the AC verification or AC analysis with respect to gain and frequency. As the frequency increases from 1 Hz to around 10 to 1 megahertz, 100 megahertz, the gain of this amplifier remains constant. If I increase more than 100 megahertz, the gain of the amplifier starts reducing and almost becomes zero. So this is the study of AC analysis. Okay, we have to get this waveform for common source. So this is about the schematic of common source amplifier. Similarly, we have to do it for layout. Okay, so what I will do? So it's very simple. First, select PMOS, select NMOS. So now, again, right click on the library name, create new cell. Now I have to select the layout. Name should be same. That is, here I written CSM. So here also I'll write CSM. So now then click on OK. So select that one, plus mark. So select it. Go to the components. So first I need PMOS. So click on PMOS here. Place it on the ground. Sorry, on the grid. So now, first thing, go to the tools. Okay, simulation spice, set spice mode. You will get this one. So here, then select it completely. Okay, then press Control I, click on text, remove others, then apply. Okay. So zoom it so that you can see properly. So now move the cursor on spice model, remove it, double click, name it as PMOS. So now you have to make the width of this PMOS to 50. So double click on it, make the width as 50. Then apply. Okay. So we got the PMOS now. Similarly, we need for this PAT to create drain and source terminal. So click on PAT, place it on the grid. So check that there should not be any connections between these layers first. So move it a little bit lower, double click on it, then select the size as 50, same as PMOS. Apply. Okay, I need another one. I will copy this Control C, then I will place above this PMOS. So Control V, place somewhere here. I will zoom out so that I can do the proper connection. So this is for PMOS. So now place them properly according to the alignment, then connect them. So left click here at this end, right click on this one. So connect. Similarly for this, left click on this part and right click on this, so connect it. So then place them by keeping in mind that this should be 0.5. So if in your tools it is not 0.5, so click on this, go to the grid preferences. Okay, here select the size as 5, that is smallest size. Okay, 0.5 technology we are going to use. So then apply. Okay, if it is not in your tool, I have to make it as 0.5. So now, so we have to connect them with the active spacer. So I move this one, so until it shows the error, that is 3. So here, P active 3, concentrate on the white color here, which is showing for the proper connection. Now, it is proper connected, leave it. Similarly for this one also, move it and connect, so that we can align it properly. Now it is correct. P active spacing is also 3. So place it properly. So now we got PMOS. So select completely. Press Ctrl J. So now PMOS is ready. Similarly, I have to do it for NMOS. So click on NMOS. Place it on the grid. Go to the tools. Simulation spice. Set spice model. So we got this one. Then select it completely. So next, press Control I. So click on text. So remove others. Apply. Okay. Then click outside. Then move this one so that you can make it as NMOS. So done. So I'm zooming it so that we can view it properly. So we got NMOS there. Now I have to change the size. So double click. Make the width as 10, as we done in the schematic. For this, we need two NACs. So one NAC I'm going to place below this one here. So place it properly. Make the width as 10. Make size 10. So apply. Okay. I need another one. So Control C, copy it. Place it above here. Control V, it will come here. Place it. So make some proper spacing to do the connections. So I'll zoom out here. Now we'll do the connection. So left click. So check that they are properly aligned, and then connect them. So left click here, right click. So done. So left click here, right click. Done. Now move it and do the connection which is shown around. So I'll zoom it to see it proper. So it should show only 3. Active spacing should be 3 and properly aligned. See here. This white line which is highlighting here, it is properly aligned with this N boss. Now leave it with N active spacing is 3. So again, now to do it for this one also. So move it and place it properly with the 3. So done. So we got N boss now. So I'll zoom out here so that we can view properly. So now select it, press Ctrl J to rotate. So now this is done. So here NMOS, which is near to the PMOS. So because of that, I will rotate 2 times so that I can get the NMOS below. Done. So now I got PMOS and NMOS. Okay, I'll zoom out. See here, we got PMOS and NMOS. So now we'll go for the pin selection. So here, for pin selection, we need VNet, VBAS. So both are connected to the gate of PMOS and NMOS. So I need here this pin which I am going to use for VIN and VBAS. This pin, polysilicon pin. So click on this, place it on the grid. So this becomes VIN. And first I will name it as Control E, make it as VIN. Same name which is given in the schematic. Click on input. Okay. So I'll zoom it so that we can view properly. So this becomes VIN. Next, we go for the second NMOS, VBIOS. Click on the polysilicon pin, place here, press Ctrl E, make it as VBIOS. Spelling mistake should not be done. Again, it is input. Okay. So we got VIN and VBIOS. So another 3 pins required. One is supply, and one is VSS, and one is output. So now for supply, we need for PMOS, we need NVEL. So click on NVEL. Okay, so place it on the grid. So somewhere place it, zoom out. Place it above the PMOS here. Now zoom in so that we can view it proper. Now for this, so double click on it here. So we need more power because the width of the PMOS is around 50. So choose 11 also. If you get the errors, just increase the size of this end. So now we'll try with 11 size. If we got errors that there is not sufficient power to the PMOS, then we'll change the size. Now we'll keep it as 11 itself. Then we'll apply. Then okay. So we got this one. So now place it properly, alignment. Okay. So it is aligned properly. Now for this I need supply. So Control E, make it as VDD, then make it as power. Then click on OK. So we got this one. So next is we need for NMOS, we need NVEL. So select, PVEL, click on PVEL, place it on the grid below the NMOS. So this is sufficient because the size is 10 here. Double click, we will keep the same it is. Now Control E, make it as VSS, then select it as ground. So done, we click on OK. The last pin we need is VOUT. So for that we will take a metal pin. So click on this, place it in between drain terminal. So here somewhere here I will click place it. So then I will press Ctrl E and I will make it as VOUT. Then change the characteristic as OUT. Then OK. So once we got this, now we have to do the connections. First I will complete VIN. So we'll zoom it so that we can view proper. So here, place VIN properly in the same grid so that no extra component should be taken. So left click, so right click. So it is connected properly, VIN. Now check for the VBIOS. So are they in the same position? Yes. Then left click, right click. So connected properly. So we're done with the inputs. Now we'll go for the power. So check that are they in the same alignment. Otherwise, correct them properly. Now on the same alignment. So here, left click, so right click, connected. Now place it, so now properly. So it is somewhat extra we got here. So align it properly. Okay, can move somewhat closer also. Done. So now we'll go for the NVEL, for NMOS PVEL. So this takes some time. So concentrate properly. So left click, right click. So here I got extra metal. See here, means the alignment is not proper. Select this metal and delete. So here also I got the metal, so which is not removed. So I'll first move this one like this. So this is the metal which is placed there, delete. So check that are they aligned properly. So we'll verify once again. Okay, it is connected properly. Okay, it is connected properly. So again, I have to place them with the active spacing 3 with proper alignment. Done. This is also done. So now we have to connect this in a proper way. So I'll move this one. So now we'll try to connect. So left click, right click. See, disconnected now. Still I've got some extra metal here. So little bit I'll move to this one. So delete. This is the extra metal I got. Delete. So now let us move it somewhere left side. Then connect it. Now it is connected properly. So move towards this one so that we can place it. Done. So this is for VSS. Last one is VOUT. So for VOUT, so drain and drain need to be connected. So zoom in, so zoom out. So now this to this, drain to drain. Because both sources are connected to the supply. So connect them. And from here, I will connect the output. So this takes much metal, place near to it like this. So then left click, right click, connect. So this is the schematic for the common source amplifier. I hope it is clear for everyone. So now this is common source amplifier layer. So now I will write the schematic, and then you have to place spice code. Go to the miscellaneous, click on miscellaneous, click on spice code, place it on the grid. Then press Ctrl I. So you will get this one, then select multiline text. So remove this and then you have to paste. So here I think I copied that one, but it is not present. Go here, again I will go it for spice code. First this one, Ctrl C, click on this, and here I have to place Ctrl V. Then for transient analysis, I have to type dot TRAN zero 10. Then click on apply. Okay. So we have written the spice code. Okay, so we got the spice code now. Next, go to the tools. So first I will set it properly. Okay. So now go to tools, check for the errors in this, check hierarchically. For that, go to the explorer. See here, no errors found in this layer. So that if you've got the errors, you know how to remove the errors. So have to check each and every error and then have to delete them. Now I got no errors, so I'll go to the tools, simulation spice, and then click on write spice deck. So maximize, click on this traces, first input, got this window, then add plot pane, then traces, click on layout, we got the same. You again got the same waveform. One is the input with 5 millivolts, one is the output with 1.612 amplified output with 180 degree phase shift. Similarly, you have to do it for DC and another one, AC analysis. I hope you can do it on your own about DC and transient, which you have done in the schematic. Then close it. So we got the complete schematic and layout for common source and common drain amplifier. Okay. So hope it is clear for everyone. So go through this and verify. Okay, so thank you.